Thank you so much for having me in your beautiful home. So, today I'm here to help you choose the best color for your project. Do you have an idea for a shade? Okay, so if I may suggest, we'll do a quick sampling. We'll come back to this in a little bit again. First color that your eye is drawn to can be any shade. Gray, black, brown, red, blue, purple. Is there one that sort of sticks out? Doesn't matter the intensity. So is there one? So how we're gonna work is whatever color you choose. So the thing is, we most of the time pick a color that is too saturated to be in a large space, especially on the wall. So what I like to do is finding you a more muted palette, a more neutral shade of that color, and it simply means that it has enough of gray to dim down the intensity of the color, because honestly, saturated colors can be hard to live with, because, you know, they start to glow in the natural light, and we want something more comfortable for our eye. So neutral shades of that color will create a more cohesive look, something that I promise you will enjoy experiencing in your space. Okay, so we'll look at different samples. I also have different flooring for us to consider for this room, okay? Since you're going to be painting, so we know what it is, okay? And then I'll have a few simple paints for us to actually test out on the wall, okay? I also see you have furniture. Would you mind if I quickly find the tone for it so that I can match everything and create a similar hue and tone? Okay, so let me do that real quick. Okay. Most likely linen, right? Okay. So it looks like quite a neutral tone. Let me try finding some in this section. Actually. So this seems to me to be the closest shade. It's about white. Okay. That's too dark. It's between these shades. Okay, so I'm gonna write that down. Okay. So I'm making notes about all the shades we're going to use. Let me show you some samples of paint that I think you're going to love, okay? Okay, so let's see. So since you said we're going to look into kind of this taupey pink mauve shade, right? Okay. I'll try opening it up for you more. And if you see one, please do speak up. So these are more cooler tones. I like this Paris Romance color. I like also this Peace and Happiness, but it will show up a bit more purple. Not this, okay. Do you think you want to look at more grays? Kind of taupe grays, maybe? Tones. This will be the mauve mist. Quite nice. There as well. That reminds me of the color that you have. Here are more taupes. And this hazel has a bit of undertone, I think Desert Light as well. Kitten Whiskers. Okay. look at neutrons. Do you like to see that trend for 2024? It could be not for everyone. So this is the trendiest color this year. Color of the year called Limitless. It's kind of creamy, creamy yellow undertone to it. But there are other tones too. And of course, there's some neutral palettes. Our glass looks wonderful. Dust Bunny too. And this is Dust Bunny on the wall here. I did want to show you the Grays collection. Okay, so you can actually see that this one, this clay color, has a bit of that same mauve undertone. So that's this one, but definitely more of a gray. Okay. Any of these sort of catch your eye? Okay. This one's cool. Let's look at it later. We should take a look at the Pear One Coat Hide Neutral Shades. Why neutral? Because you can combine then cool tone furniture, warm furniture, warm, cool. I'm sorry. You'll be able to combine cool and warm details, furnishings to make a more cohesive look. Good colors here. You like this one? Yeah. I was actually thinking about this one. So it's called the Wheat Bread. And why don't we look at the one right next to it? And this one's called Smoke Stack. It does have a bit of that mauve undertone. They're both two. Which again gives you a little bit of kind of a gray, warm, cool tone, very neutral. Yep. This one definitely more cooler tone, kind of gives off more of a gray blue tone. But these are very comforting. What do you think about this shade? So it's a bit darker, but it could be more warming. So we can really look at three of those colors, so we can decide on one of them, yeah? I do can see a bit of that mauve pushing through, you see it? Yep. So maybe we have three. One, two, and the other one, Studio Taupe, okay? Okay, great. You're welcome to look at more. Yeah. Just don't get the paralysis analysis. Analysis paralysis, whatever it's called. So these are warm tones. Honestly, looking at the furniture you have right now, I'll do more neutrals, but it's up to you. Of course. I can keep my advice to myself too, but I'm here to help. This loft light, not bad. All of these are too much, right? Mm-hmm. At least for this room. It would definitely create a bit more moody effect. So this is the color of the year. The color of the year by Bear. And it's this almost black color. Cracked pepper. It would look amazing in matte. And again, more structural rooms like this. They would have to be dressed for this occasion. But, you know, different styles for everyone. Mm-hmm. Oh, yes, I think light would be a bit too much of a contrast. And actually could create like a blinding effect. So you might want to actually keep it down with more natural pieces of wood, darker tone wood. Mm-hmm. It's quite moody, yes. And here I think it would be a perfect use for trim, doors. I think that would be the best color for that. This has been a very trendy color too. These muted, very earthy tones, very satisfying, very pleasant for a lot of people to live with. But, you know, for others, it becomes sort of a lack of color. So, but you can always decorate it, right? Get more color through artwork and blankets, pillows, and knickknacks. Okay? Other design elements. Okay. So I'm going to try and find those colors for you in bigger size. So these two, so far, are my favorite, because they're actually very similar, but this has just a bit more tone to it, and the lighting might be different, but it does have a bit of this kind of playful mauve shade, okay? Might be harder to see under light. So let's see a different wood. So here's the red oak. Definitely cools it down. Without it, this is quite a warm tone. But here it creates contrast and cools it a bit. Picks up the coolness, right? Okay. Here's a by the sea oak. This is double cool. Makes it much cooler than without paint. Here's the wheat bread with it. bed to go. Okay. Here's a French oak with a smokestack. Brings up almost a green undertone. Do you like it? Only work better. This is a French oak baker. It's called. Definitely a bit more green also, kind of more brown, but also very nice contrast. A little bit of green. That's the smokestack. This is the wheat bread. Wheat bread looking good. Okay. Which one did you like? So if it was up to me, I think that would be my color. This will be my second choice, of course, just as yours. This one's on. Okay. Both look pretty good. I actually have a cup that's mauve shade. As you can see, all of this works quite beautifully. Okay. Okay. So I would like to do a couple of swatches on the wall. They're kind of portable swatches. These two and of the studio taupe, because I think we want one more tone that's a bit darker for us to try, okay? Okay, let's do it. So I just place this to protect the surface. Swatches that I'm going to paint for you. Okay. Let's see. So smoke stack first. And I'll use this roller to apply it. Okay. things. Let's let it dry for a few minutes. You can already see the pretty color. So next is Studio Taupe. So here is Studio Taupe. Very beautiful shade. Okay, so I'll just put it on our sample case. So that's our second one, Studio Taupe. It is definitely a darker shade, you can tell, but it looks beautiful. Okay, I'll put it right here. And last is Wheat. Clumping, that's okay. So here is our wheat bread. Very beautiful neutral tone. It's also beautiful, very kind of neutral. Swedish, as people like to call them, so it's grey and beige. I do see a little bit of warm undertone, but let's see how it dries. Okay, and then we'll take a look. So our samples, swatches, are dry. So I'm going to place them on the wall for you for comparison, okay? So let's see. So this is the smokestack, okay? Smokestack, Studio Taupe. And so this one is the last one. It is our wheat bran. Leave this for you. You can live with them for a few days, okay? So again, wheat bread. I'll write down the names here. Wheat bread, smokestack, and studio taupe. These are also removable, so you can actually unpeel them and take them to another room. Like that. Okay. Take him to another room or to a different location if you wish. Okay. You will not damage the existing surface. Smoke stack. This one is my favorite for you, but it's up to you truly. Okay. And Studio Taupe. Beautiful color, a bit more deeper shade, okay? Okay, so please let me know in a couple of days what decision you have made. And order the painting.